always get asked loads of questions because Flash Mob has just had its fifth birthday and celebration cup. And so people obviously are finding Flash Mob like now. And of course, we started it back.
Long time ago.
Yeah. Sitting on the South Bank in London.
Frustrated. I always like that James song.
We almost started crying about. You had some stuff at work going on, and we were sat in deck chairs in South Bank, which, if anybody who knows London, it's not really deck chair, you know, place. But
no, and we struggled getting out of them at times. They were.
Yeah.
When you've had a few drinks, they're not the easiest things to
We weren't sat there with your handkerchiefs and knots and stuff. Obviously, you can probably tell from the accents that we're both not Londoners.
Yelling abuse at people walking past.
Yeah, so Northerners in London. A little bit of background. I used to work in PMOs. I don't anymore, thank God. No, I don't really mean that. But Ralph, you were a PMO consultant. You still are, but
yeah.
You were then.
Yeah.
And I remember you had a bit of a to-do. I can't even remember you were working for
PMO. And I'll tell you what the other thing we did. We've been both doing work for other organisations, and we just really got frustrated. And what's it, both being Manx, you know, that James song, Born of Frustration.
I'm not a Manx, I'm from Yorkshire.
So Born of Frustration, and I think that's where it came from. You know, like just getting really frustrated over people not listening to what PMOs should be about, and what they are about, and what they do. And people would say, oh, you know, just go and, you know, if you run a PMO, go take minutes at a meeting, go book some travel, and yeah. And we were going, no, it's not about that. You know, with these other organisations, we're writing stuff up. So we just said, wouldn't it be great if we'll get a group of like-minded people together? And I guess that's where Flash Mob came from, where you just randomly put out adverts to complete strangers. Do you want to turn up and talk about PMOs?
Yeah, do you want to turn up in a pub?
Yeah.
In fact, the first one was actually on a boat on the Thames. And we didn't do the own work properly, because it weren't even a boat. It was like a restaurant on a pub. On a boat, and it didn't really have a bar or anything, so we just like kind of
we didn't know we were going to turn up. We didn't even know we were going to turn up. We just sent adverts out in papers saying, are you lonely tonight? Do you need some friends?
Yeah, the equivalent. We had about because what we said was it'd be really good, because it'd be almost like a when you get a load of PMO people together, it's like a coaching circle. Like everybody's like really like, oh yeah, I know exactly what you mean, yeah, I've been through that, blah, blah, blah. It's like PMO Anonymous, but
PMO
is Flash Mob.
Mine is Ralph, and I run a PMO.
it's a bit like that. But I thought, well, actually, if you do it in a pub, we'll see what happens, and that's what we did.
I'll tell you the other bit that came from it as well, though. You said, like, as PMOs, a lot of people tend to either work on their own a PMO of one, or if they do, it's in a
pot.
What's a pot?
PMO of two.
Oh, it could be three. Or 12.
Yeah, it could be. Or 20.
Yeah.
But
so
anyway,
there you go.
So this is the kind of stuff you talk about, Flash.
Right.
In the when we do the ones in the pub, it is about. We're not saying it's just like, you know, toilet humour, but yeah, that's how you get.
But we did say though,
talking.
Yeah, we did say though, like if you're a project manager, you're mixing with other project managers all the time. PMOs don't tend to mix. You go into an organisation, you tend to be the only PMO. That was the world back then.
Yeah.
And wouldn't it be great if you could just try and meet up with other PMOs and share your war stories and your pain you're going through and the challenges and
And it is funny, isn't it? Because people used to come. Well, we're still doing now. It's still going, but. When we first started out, people are coming. They'd be like, "It's like people here that are like talking about the same stuff and problems that I've got. I've got exactly the same thing going on." And we're like, "Well, why are you surprised? why are you doing this job in a while?" But that was the problem, because I've never actually come across people before. And I remember the first one we did. And we were just like, we managed. I think we got about 8 people just turned up, and we've not even actually thought about, well, what do we do now, really?
I think I ran to the bar straight away.
Well, I got a bit like, oh, this is awful, what do we do? And I said, right, okay, I'll tell you what we'll do. Let's just, like, throw a question in, and then let's just see where it goes, shall we? You know, everybody's just like, but it was really good, because the drinks flowed, and, we were on the Thames, and you've got Big Ben there, and it was just like, you know, it was really good, so we carried on doing it, and yeah, it was just, it's 50 year of this, and now we're in London.
And it's all changed.
In 2018, now we're at PMO conferences. You know, it started pretty much. Well, basically, he buggered off to Australia, and it's like he left me. What am I going to do now with Flash Mob now? The Wreck-It Ralph's gone.
Yeah, but I did the exec role. I set the direction and the vision, and then left you to deliver it, and then I turn up 4 years later and take credibility. But the difference being is, you sold out. You've gone all Disney on us now. You know, it's
Disney.
Like it's fucking merchandise. I just swear.
Sean Ray.
Yeah. It's like you've gone all merchandise on us.
I know.
You know.
Well, you know,
available all quality good stores.
Yeah. But I tell you what, people
and
love
online.
It. I think people love it. It's
it is good actually.
Some of the stuff we have, like we've got like I love PMA stickers, and a number of people have said to me, this is really funny having these in the office because nobody loves PMO in there.
A bit of irony there, isn't there?
Well, give the sticker to your boss then, or just like put it in his laptop when he's not looking, and then you know. But
I took a load for me to take back to Shreya.
Yeah, I think it's a different vibe, and that's what we wanted to have, because, you know, project management. You know, to be fair, PMO people can go and learn about project management wherever. It's all over the place. But, you know, we just thought, well, if you're going to do something with PMO people, and actually part of it was personalities that we wanted to have a bit of fun with it. And it's the name, and to be fair, I keep thinking about it, it's like the name now.
Yeah.
Don't you think it's really bizarre? Because back in 5 years ago, Flash Mob used to be a thing, didn't it? Like people at the train station.
Yeah, turning
like
up for like lightsaber fights and dances and that, and then
Yeah. I don't know what to do. Whether you think it like it's dated, or should we just keep it? And eventually, it'll be retro.
I don't know. I think it sticks. I mean, well, you know.
People like it because it stands out, and it was just like, oh, what's this?
But also, I think we just did something different, didn't we? I mean, the branding and that, which obviously you take credit for. We've always talked about this. I'm the brains, and you make it look nice. Yeah. I genuinely think, though, that the branding is part of it, where people just don't see it as one of these old, fussy, dated... And they actually see it as new and contemporary. And to be fair, a lot of it is, because a lot of the stuff that gets produced isn't stuff that's been produced on what people were thinking 5 years ago, and finally someone's got their act together to try and, you know, put it in a book. The stuff that is being talked about is here and now, you know, all the challenges people are facing into. And I think people like it for that reason. And, you know.
I tell you, it's funny, Krista, that the word flash mob, it does still exist, because we get inquiries, because we've got a website. Inquiries come through the website. Just getting in touch. I'm looking to organise a flash mob for my daughter's wedding.
And we also do bat fitzmas and funerals.
So yes, it's just very, very bizarre.
Can you imagine a flash mob at a funeral? That'd be awesome, wouldn't it? Just like
no. But like Michael Jackson's Thriller.
No. Jeez, no. And maybe I'll do that. I might put it in my will. Said I want a lightsaber flash mob at my funeral. I want to see the vicar's face when everybody runs into a church with a lightsaber.
So basically, what we also decided to do was
gone all Disney again.
I mean, what is it?
Merchandise.
Yeah.
Go on. Anyway.
Yeah. So basically, we found that not everybody particularly enjoys or feels comfortable with the social bit of actually walking into a pub. But also, I think we just felt that there was, because there was so much stuff to be tattled, and silly is obviously, we thought, well, actually, it would be quite nice to have a few new sessions, a bit more what we call, I come up with these names over the years. I think it what was it something like live and learn, that was it.
Live and learn.
Yeah, no, it's a bit rubbish, isn't it? A bit Peter and John and Pat.
Live and learn. It's the sort of thing your mum had said to you when you fall off your bike as a kid. You'd be like, "Ah, mum, oh, you'll live and learn."
So essentially, these things were. Well, people that wanted to come and listen to somebody else sharing their wisdom, so like more like a lecture, but still like, you know, obviously, So basically, that what's happened since that point is that we thought, well, we might as well record it for people that don't necessarily live in London or whatever. But we didn't realise that, you know, obviously there's people all over the world can just quite easily become a. You can sign up on the Flash Mob website. You don't pay anything, and you can just access all these videos. Mm. So it's been really interesting. I always think this back. We were sat in a deck chair in South Bank, And there, there's like people dropping me a line from like parts of India and Australia and America and say, oh, we really like that video and blah, 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 this thing, God. You know, I think they think that we know what we're doing. You know what I mean? But it's like, but it, yeah.
We make it look like we don't know what we're doing. But really, inside, there's a massive machine behind it sorting it all out.
No, there isn't a massive machine. It's just me. But essentially, so he buggered off to Australia. How long ago now?
4 years. Four years ago.
And he's just starting Flash Mob.
Down under.
He's actually
So we got it. So I left the UK with GMO, and then obviously arrived in Australia, and then now POM.
So Australia then. So what? So how is it different to here?
It's warmer.
To London.
You did
GMO
ask.
What?
It's a lot warmer. Yeah, I mean, people told me the weather was going to be really bad in the UK, and I don't think it's that bad.
I'm not bothered about the weather.
No, but it's not. I mean, this is quite nice for winter.
Well, your winter.
Oh, is this not your
business? It's June.
Righto.
So go on, what's the difference? Is there a difference?
Yeah, well...
Is there?
Yeah.